dun, 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 dun. Baby, we were born to run. Yee! Dun, 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 dun. We were born to run. We were born to run.
I'm really glad that you saw the show last night.
Are you?
Yes. As we're here, and it could have been a shame to have missed it. It was absolutely fantastic, wasn't it?
It was, wasn't it?
I said, did you get my cake? Did you get my cake?
Might have. On the other hand, I might have been too embarrassed to be seen buying that type of junk.
Nothing wrong with a bit of cake.
No, not if you're a couch potato with a burning desire for diabetes. Have you not heard of the national sugar addiction? The obesity epidemic they're always on about?
They're always on about something. You can't keep up with everything.
No, well, I'm sure that's what the dinosaurs said before breathing in their last.
How can I help you?
How much sugar is in a Victoria sponge cake?
Let me think about that. 100 grams of Victoria sponge cake contains 37 grams of sugar.
Ah!
Maybe I should ask her to get my cake.
Whose is all this? There's a week's worth of shopping in here.
Sorry, I didn't take it home in case the vultures have it. Along with my tea bags, my shampoo, and the two tubs of peanut butter they've already had this week.
Two tubs?
Yeah, I think Tim and his girlfriend have found some new and original use for it. Told you I needed help.
Oh, hope it's the smooth kind.
Leatherbridge Life, you want a subscription or something?
No, they want to do an interview about my app.
Oh, nice one.
Nah, I think I'm going to give it a miss. You should totally speak to him about Peanut Buttergate.
Yeah. Well, I've got nothing better to do since Anthony got the boot, have I?
Yeah, well, from the gossip I've heard, we're well read. And things will start falling into place, especially now you've got Zara in your pocket. Not to mention yours truly fight in your corner, and we'll work out where to live later, yeah?
Okay. Morning.
Morning.
The design was fantastic, and the staging.
Yeah, and the acting.
I must have been, I've never seen Cymbeline before, but it was very interesting, wasn't it, having a woman in the title role?
Yeah, oh, did you know that A Midsummer Night's Dream's on tour? And it's supposed to be just as good.
Yeah, unfortunately, they're not coming to Liverpool.
Yeah, their bottom is supposed to be fantastic.
I've seen quite a few interesting bottoms in my time.
Yeah, well, in our line of work, Dr. Carter.
In fact, I played him once.
Oh, I'd like to have seen your bottom. I don't want us to be at odds.
We better get going. We don't want to be late.
Wasn't much to ask.
Yes, well, a little here, a little there, everything starts to build up, doesn't it? Till it's sucking you dry, and you know that you've got the sticky end of the stick, where all my bills keep going up and up, and your flaming house just keeps on appreciating.
Well, rest assured, no amount of money could compensate for living with you.
Likewise, I'm sure, but without me, you'd starve, wouldn't you?
Worth it.
So is being on the streets. The only thing keeping me here is the hope of seeing you off.
Likewise, I'm sure.
Well, good luck with that, Darth Vader. Do you want to get that or shall I?
So, did you get my bloody cake or not?
Well, why don't you just hop over there and look for yourself? I've got to get warmed up.
I'm Aisha from the Mill Health Centre. Tash's up sick today, so I'm just covering her home visits.
Right you are. Invalids in there. No.
Nearly done.
Can't you do that somewhere else?
Not enough room.
No privacy in my own home.
Oh, pardon me for breathing.
Well, if you promise not to do it for much longer.
It's very good for the old cardio. I've been telling him for years to get himself into shape and get out there, get some of his air from the sky instead of a bottle.
Well, a bit of exercise can help. Whatever you can manage, really. I've got some info on rehabilitation courses back at the surgery.
Yes, spring has sprung, birds are singing, the sap is rising.
Mine isn't, not anymore.
So are you two a couple?
Once upon a time, when we were a touch younger and much gayer...
After I came out to my family in 92...
93?
No, it was...
I would hardly forget the beginning of the end.
Of your teeth, you mean?
Anyway, we moved in together and in a fit of insanity struck a deal.
I'd pay the whole mortgage on this place.
And I would pay all the rest of the bills. So now...
It was like a marriage of convenience.
Worst deal ever.
And least convenient.
So, my dear, in answer to your question, we're trapped together in domestic bliss.
OK. I'll just take your blood pressure.
So, welcome to the Royal Shakespeare Theatre here on the bank of the River Avon. Now, as we already know, all the world's a stage. But today, here in Shakespeare's hometown of Stratford-upon-Avon, we're going to go beyond that to peep behind the fringed curtains on the backstage tour.
Oh, it's very
now,
good.
That being
and
said,
memorizing his lines, considering he's about
you'll see on the tour,
12.
As this is a working-based theatre and it depends entirely on what's going on today. But that's all part of the excitement of the tour. So, my name's Toby.
Oh, Toby, do you take after your namesake?
And without further ado...
Sir Toby Belch, possess us, tell us something of him.
Let's take a look behind the scenes.
By all means. Wherefore are these things hid? Wherefore have these gifts a curtain before them?
Right.
It's all right, love. No need to sugarcoat it.
Yes, go on. Got to be cool to be kind.
I know it's going to kill me, just not today, thank you.
Well, just give us the date. I'll make sure not to miss it. Meanwhile, I'm off on my power walk, trying to push past 5 miles a day.
5 miles to nowhere.
Recorded, verified, and posted online by my tracker app. Thank you very much.
All modcons, aren't we?
Well, you need something to organise your social engagements and busy modern lifestyle, don't you? Yes, of course, you're living in the past and have no friends.
Right. Well, your oxygen's a bit low, so I'll get that sorted. Are you sure you've got enough support living at home? Is there anyone else looking out for you?
No, I'll be all right. You can always rely on him for the kiss of life. Anyway, I've got my daughter, Sam, coming for tea this afternoon.
It's weird the difference one person can make, isn't it? The house feels, well, so much quieter without me, almost empty.
That's hardly surprising.
No, looks like Aisha's going to be packing her bags.
Well, count yourself lucky. What I wouldn't give for just some space without Joe and Daniel in my ear every 5 minutes. At least you can put Chris up without him tripping over everyone.
Yes, I'll remember that the next time he, you know, pops over from Australia for a long weekend. Anyway, listen, I wanted to ask your opinion about social worker Jane Fairweather.
I have come across her once or twice.
It's just that she's told me some things about a pregnant patient that have rather made me doubt my own judgment.
Well, I'd say that she's professional and she would have the best interests of the child at heart.
I mean, I knew this patient had a history. She just seems so together now. What Jane told me made my hair stand on end.
Well, we meet all kinds of people. Don't be husky. Capable of all kinds of things, I suppose.
Uh-huh.
It's just, you know, I can't quite believe that a mother would do that to a child. I mean, your own flesh and blood.
Tell me about it. Human nature never ceases to amaze me.
I'm sorry, excuse me.
Carmichael puts her foot in it once again.
What?
Well, she was clearly upset. You know, she's bound to be sensitive about babies and, you know, after we lost Howard.
Well, clearly I'm the idiot.
You said it.
Thank you.
I'm not eating your half-chewed biscuits.
You didn't say Sam was coming.
Did you think I'd eat the whole cake by myself?
Well, I should stay.
No, no, you've got your important walk to nowhere, and your phone will be miffed if you don't turn up. Anyway, Sam said she wants a chat.
So, here we have the quick change area. Oh, with a rail of costumes. These are from a production of A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Get your apparel together, good strings to your beards, new ribbons to your pumps.
Have a look.
Great, look at that.
Oh, but please don't touch.
Oh, it's Puck.
Now, the most important rule of quick change dressing, I'm told, is not to panic. I mean, if you're racing to hit your cue, you do not want to find yourself wrestling with a straitjacket.
Maybe you'll get to see my bottom after all.
Oh, yeah.
Unless, of course, a straitjacket is called for.
Well, what do you say? An asset of your own, do you?
As by my faith, I see no more in you.
There's no more faith in thee than a stewed prune.
Which makes him prune himself and bristle up the crest of youth against your dignity.
Very good. Please give me a hand. I'm sure I can.
Sorry.
There we go. Okay. It's nice.
My girl!
You're not staying?
No, on a tight schedule. You know me.
I was hoping to catch you both.
Everything okay?
Oh, yeah, with me everything's fine. It's just, Dad's emphysema getting worse. I was thinking about getting him to come and live with us.
Makes sense.
But I wanted to check you'd be okay with it.
Okay? I'd be made up. I've been waiting for an excuse to ditch the old gift for years. And it's not like I haven't had any offers, believe me. Better fly, I'm on the old clock. Wish him happy trails. Eh?
You're really young to know so much.
Oh, I studied postgrad at the Shakespeare Institute.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, wow.
So, here we are, on stage, in the actor's shoes, as it were.
Can you imagine the audience just hanging on to every word? All that energy.
Yeah, imagine.
Well, life is full of missed opportunities. Ah! Romeo and Juliet. Actually, we had a load of year 10s through earlier, and I had the troublemakers up doing the balcony scene, which separated the men from the boys.
Romeo and Juliet?
Yeah. I mean, perhaps you'd like to show us how it's done.
Oh, I don't think.
Oh, no, come on. Come on, you're dying to.
If it were done when 'tis done, then so well it were done quickly. Break a leg.
How camest?
Camest.
Thank you. How camest thou hither? Tell me, and wherefore?
Flirtier.
The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death, considering who thou art. If any of my kinsmen find thee here.
With love's light wings did I o'erperch these walls.
Miles, game over, thank you and good night. The numbers don't lie.
Averaging 25 miles an hour.
That's the statistical anomaly. Sam gone already?
Yes, she heard you skidding up on Shanks's pony.
Didn't you want a serious word? Thought maybe she'd suss she couldn't possibly be biologically related.
It was nothing important.
Will you give it up? I know you're after moving in over there.
What? You know nothing of the sort.
She told me, you gold-plated ignoramus.
No, she...
She actually has a smidgen of integrity, presumably from her mother's half of the gene pool.
Why?
So hasta la vista, baby. Enjoy your assisted living.
I said no.
You said no, why? You don't know you're born, do you? Or what you have in that girl.
She's my daughter.
Well, you don't deserve her. I mean, look at the state of you. I don't know why she bother. And then you go and throw it back in her face. You must...
Oh, wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of thy love's faithful vow for mine.
Well, I gave thee mine before thou did request it. And yet I would it were to give it again.
Okay, that's enough of that.
Oh, come on, just carry on.
I think maybe we could all do with a break.
Oh, come on, more.
If it's just getting interesting.
It's ridiculous.
Heston?
It's hardly appropriate casting.
It was just a bit of fun.
You know, if you were really some soppy teenager and I was in the throes of some hormone-fueled crush, but we're not, are we? Henceforth, I never will be Romeo.
That ship has sailed. After cash, I'm a bit short.
Come on.
Badger is dead.
You can't even stand to lose this race, can you?
I don't understand. Why did you tell her, though?
Oh, you wouldn't. Well, she's got her own life. Family. Didn't need me cluttering up the place.
No.
I like them visiting, being fun, Granddad, remembered like that, not some old zombie coughing over his cornflakes every morning. And I can't stand a fella.
Me neither.
Patronizing. If you pop your clothes, I'll have to live with him. Old Top Gear, 24/7.
Thought you wanted rid of me.
Oh, good point. Just plug the phone in, will you, and call her back. Anyway, who would I have to talk to about the past? All that, eh? Who was actually there?
Hardly matters now, anyway. Be in the past soon enough.
No.
Both of us at death's door. Grim Reaper knocking. You did hear that, didn't you?
Hello? Anyone home? I brought that info. Oh, my. Right, just don't move. Stay there.
Not a problem.
Come in, just... Give me a sec.
Watch my weight whimsies.
Stop your weight whimsies.
What on earth happened?
Limbo competition. Got out of hand.
We've all been there.
Look at him first. He's the invalid.
Yes, ambulance.
He can talk.
And you can't, which is a relief to all.
Oh, be quiet, both of you. 37, Birch Close, Leatherbridge. And your chest hurting, is it?
First my leg, now this.
He was coughing blood.
Your leg where?
Pulled a muscle days ago.
Yes, suspected pulmonary embolism. Yeah, ASAP.
Is that bad?
You remember earlier when you said you didn't want me to sugarcoat it? Right, let's try and get you up.
No curtain call, then. You know, I'm assuming this isn't about Romeo and Juliet.
Rumour. I've come to realise that I'm going to die sooner rather than later.
No, because you've had treatment.
I'm not talking about the angina. This heart has a history. One careless owner, I probably couldn't give it away. Not that I haven't tried. Sorry, I didn't mean that. It just seems very important to me that I'm older and I'm less healthy.
Not to me.
I know you want to take things slowly, but I'm not sure I have that luxury. I should never have asked you to move in the first place. I mean, what do I have to offer, really, in terms of life and a future? We should probably catch up before it's too late.
Oh. Hey.
Listen, I'm with a really poorly
patient. I'm not going to make it back for lunch.
Oh, okay.
I'll grab a sandwich. Will I see you later?
Yeah, the thing is, there's something I wanted to run by you.
Right.
I know it's bad timing and Neve's just gone and everything, but...
It's just Sid's desperate.
Look, it's fine. I understand.
I mean, you know, I'm not going to lie. I will miss your Prosecco cocktails, but we all need to move on.
Don't we?
What, you want me out?
What? No! I thought you wanted to move out.
No,
I was just going to ask if Sid could move in.
Oh.
Hello? Hello, am I breaking up?
Look, we'll talk about it later, yeah?
Yes, OK.
Oh, your dad's OK.
Uncle Tom?
Well, he very nearly wasn't if your dad hadn't come to the rescue. But he's on blood thinners as well as the oxygen. He should be OK, too.
Looks as if you won't be winning that race after all. Now look what you've done.
Sorry. And I'm sorry I got annoyed. You can be so pig-headed.
Seconded. Never you mind, I'll move in if you won't.
That offer wasn't open to all comers, so you stuck with me.
That's so. Nurse! You wouldn't have another bed on another planet.
Leave the poor girl alone. She's got enough to do without you in her ear.
Maybe I should ask for them to be moved if they're going to start winding each other up again.
No, it just makes them feeling better. It's how they keep each other going.
Straight off you.
Get off.
If you're laid up, maybe I could take charge for a change.
No chance. You can barely raise a smile most days.
I can manage. I'll get myself one of those electric chairs.
So, I'll even throw the switch.
All right, I'll talk to them. About moving in. I have no idea what they're going to say, but... they're getting older and... they're going to fly the nest and... I'm getting older, and yes, you are getting older. But life is full of missed opportunities, and I'm really aware of what we have. It's very beautiful, and it's very rare. And I want to hang on to it, if you want to.
Time of year thou mayst in me behold, when yellow leaves, or none, or few, do hang upon those boughs which shake against the cold, bare ruined choirs where late the sweet birds sang. In me thou seest the twilight of such day, as after sunset fadeth in the west, which by and by, black night doth take away death's second self that seals up all in rest. In me thou seest the glowing of such fire that on the ashes of his youth doth lie, as the deathbed, whereon it must expire, consumed with that which it was nourished by. This thou perceivest, which makes thy love more strong, to love that well which thou must leave ere long.
Dr. Clay.
Esther.
Have a pastry.
He's asked me to move in with him.
Wait.
Oh, I'm confused.
Look out!
Esther Carter, you are magnificent. My pleasure. I am also the bringer of good news. Mrs. Tembe is returning to the fold.
Yay! You give me fever.